love fan art, the artists, we're about to check out imagined their favorite My Little Pony characters as babies, young fillies, and colts. Let's explore the art and the backstory of these characters. Bet you can't guess what Rainbow Dash was like at a baby? Stick around until the end to find out. If this is your first time at the things, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and give this video a big thumbs up. Now let's jump right into My Little Pony characters growing up. Granny Smith. Granny Smith is an extremely important resident of Ponyville.
We've been hosting these things at Sweet Apple Acres every 100 moons since we first planted roots here in Ponyville. Hey, who's that?
She's the eldest member of the well-respected Apple family that earns her a lot of respect from the other ponies. She wasn't always the white-haired, wrinkled grandma we know and love. She was pretty much the cutest baby ever. Check her out, all swaddled up. Artist I Implode imagines Granny when she was just a tiny little pony. Even Granny Smith was a filly once. Artist Stabzer has imagined her in her youth. Being an elder isn't the only thing that earns her respect. On Family Appreciation Day, Granny Smith accompanies Apple Bloom to school. She's offering a presentation to Apple Bloom's class about the Apple family history. The other little ponies listen with excitement as she describes just how much she's done for Ponyville. When Granny was just a little filly, Ponyville hadn't been founded yet. Granny wandered into the ever-free forest to find food for her family. Granny herself actually discovered the magical Zap apples. The jam the Apple family made from them was so delicious that ponies came from all over Equestria to taste it. This led to Ponyville being founded and growing into the city it is today. Granny may have had the most important childhood of any character on the show. Not too many characters can say they've lived in Ponyville since the beginning. Big Macintosh. Big Macintosh is the big brother of Applejack.
This is why I don't like talking. Words can hurt. Words hurt! Goodbye, Sugar Bell.
He was also an adorable baby. Beaver Nader gives us a peek at the pony when he was tiny. His wild mop of hair is too cute. Takua 770 shows us a young wild colt Big Mac. Big brothers usually have a lot of responsibility. Not only is he a big brother, but he also grew up on a farm. He was in charge of taking care of his baby sister and all of his farm chores. His childhood was full of hard work. Growing up, he had to look out for Applejack and their little sister Apple Bloom. The Apple siblings live with their grandmother on the family farm. An older guardian often needs a lot of help, and that usually falls to the oldest. He doesn't speak very often, and when he does, his words are few. That might be because he's been so busy since he was a little colt that he never got into the habit of speaking much. His oldest sister and Granny both have a tendency to gab. Maybe he just never got a word in edgewise and has always kept quiet. Being a big, strong pony, he probably had a ton of chores on the farm, too. That would explain why he's so skilled in every part of his operation today. He's obviously very close to his sisters. His bond with them is stronger than most siblings. We think it might be because he spends so much time raising them. Scootaloo. Scootaloo is one of the youngest ponies on the show to get so much screen time.
Come on, Scootaloo. Do it for Ponyville. Just gotta try 20 times as hard. Yeah.
Thanks to the artist, Zigrock001, we get to see every stage of her development, not just when she was introduced on the show. Check out this cutie. Sugarcup91 draws her as a slightly older filly too. Her love of Rainbow Dash leads to her parents finding out that she's a Wonderbolt. That's a big plot point for such a little pony. Her origin story is shrouded in mystery. Her parents never make an appearance on the show. They're never even mentioned. In the chapter book, Ponyville Mystery, Riddle of the Rusty Horseshoe, we find out that Scootaloo doesn't even live with them. She lives with her Aunt Holiday and her Auntie Lofty. This has raised some eyebrows among fans. The book says her parents are away most of the time. Where are they away at? What could be more important than raising their daughter? My Little Pony Friendship is Magic creator Lauren Faust has given her own conflicting information. In one interview, she dropped a shocking bomb. Scootaloo doesn't have any parents. How can that be true? Where did she come from if she doesn't have a family? Later, Faust said that she did have parents, but they had demanding jobs and were away constantly. No matter which storyline is true, she definitely has one of the most mysterious childhoods of any of the ponies. Spike. Unlike most of the other characters on the show, we've seen most of Spike's childhood, including his birth. That didn't stop artist The Last Gherkin. From creating one of the cutest images of baby Spike ever, look at those big eyes, and check him out in this hat by Cutie Marks. When Twilight Sparkle was just a filly, she was accepted into Princess Celestia's School for Gifted Unicorns. After she was accepted, she had to pass an entrance exam. The exam was pretty straightforward. Twilight Sparkle had to hatch a dragon egg with magic. At first, she struggled to produce any magic effect at all. Rainbow Dash's sonic rain boom changed that. It startled Twilight Sparkle so much that all of her latent magic was released at once. Not only did she hatch Spike, but she made him the size of an adult dragon. Obviously, that was fixed because Spike is now a normal size for a dragon his age. Twilight Sparkle is really the only mother he's ever known. He was so curious about his heritage that he joined the dragon migration to learn more about his people.
Yes! I'm going on a quest of self-discovery. I need to learn what it means to be a dragon. And the only way I'm going to do that is to join the dragon migration.
What?
The other dragons he met weren't entirely welcoming. They teased him for being small and spending time with ponies. He decided that being true to himself is what matters most, and went back to Twilight Sparkle, a more confident assistant. It's pretty cool watching him grow up before our very eyes. Fluttershy. Poor little Fluttershy. Some ponies are just born talented and successful. Others struggle and have to work hard. Fluttershy was one of the ponies who struggled.
I feel good. I feel ready to attack the day, as Iron Will says.
She grew up in Cloudsdale. All the Pegasi there have to fly as part of their everyday lives. They're often judged on their flying skills. Rainbow Dash is popular because she's one of the fastest. Little Fluttershy wasn't so lucky. She was a weak flyer from the beginning and struggled to master even the basics. The same ponies that used to pick on Rainbow Dash, they were so mean and called her awful names like Klutzershy. How rude can you get? At least she was a beautiful baby. Brony Boy made this pickup baby Fluttershy, so we can all coo over her. Look how little and innocent she is. Pre-Dark imagines her as a filly in this adorable pic. It's hard not to feel bad for her. She's a sweet pony. She shows so much love and compassion for animals. She's been known to adopt and rehabilitate creatures in the forest near her cottage. Her soft-spoken and shy nature make her an easy target for bullies. As an adult, Fluttershy became an average skill flyer. She still has some problems from time to time. When she's scared, she can become incapable of flight. That's a huge problem for a pony that's afraid of so much. She has a lot of friends who love and respect her. Bullying isn't a problem for her anymore, but she's still that shy, nervous pony. Applejack. Little Applejack is so precious. Artist Scott of Fury created this sweet, happy image of the baby pony in her hat. Ellis Arts imagines her as a filly before her hair was tamed into a ponytail. As cute as she is, Applejack's childhood has a painful secret. The Apple family is huge, and they all love each other very much.
Sorry, Granny. I just decided if I helped you, it would go faster.
There do seem to be two people conspicuously missing. Applejack's parents never make a current appearance on the show. They're barely even mentioned. The show's creator, Lauren Faust, knows where they are, but she says the show will likely never allow it to be mentioned. Sadly, Applejack's parents have passed away. In the episode Apple Family Reunion, two shooting stars appeared over the family farm. Storyboard artist Sabrina Alberghetti confirmed that those stars were meant to represent Applejack's parents. We get a single glimpse of them in a flashback. In the memory, we see the love that Applejack's parents shared. Apple's dad was Bright Mac, and her mom was Pear Butter. There was a long-standing feud between the Apple and Pear families, making their love forbidden. We don't know how their Romeo and Juliet love story ended, but we know they were together at some point. We're glad they got to have their sweet daughter, but we can't help but wonder what happened to them. Pinkie Pie. Pinkie Pie definitely had one of the most strict and conservative childhoods of all the ponies. Some fans have even called her upbringing abusive. Her family is so conservative that even their coats and manes are dull, earthy colors. That doesn't stop Pinkie from being one of the cutest babies we've ever seen. DeviantArt user JRK08004 created this image of baby Pinkie. Check out how cozy she looks in her bed. Inky Beaker imagines a filly Pinkie with the fun personality we all know and love. Pinkie grew up on a rock farm where there was no talking or smiling. Her family is extremely patriarchal. What dad says goes. After the sonic rain boom, Pinkie Pie decides it's high time they start having fun. She organizes a party and surprises her family.
Surprise!
You'd expect a bunch of hardworking ponies to be excited about the chance to have some fun. The Pie family actually seemed more scared than excited. They stood around in silence, seeming to tremble until Pinky's dad showed up. Everyone stared at him, anxious to see his reaction. After he approved of the party, only then did everyone else relax and had some fun. Some fans think that that behavior was a clear sign that the family was being ruled with an iron fist. Were they simply hardworking and conservative people, or did their parents take it too far? Rarity. Baby Rarity. Look how adorable Rarity was as a newborn. Can you even handle it? Artist Brony Boy shared this gem with the world, and now we can all see her cuteness. She's even precious as a filly. Rarity 6195 created this super cute image of Rarity in formal wear. Rarity's childhood is a bit of a mystery.
If pick flowers that accentuate my mane. It makes for a captivating color story when you present them to whomever they're intended.
We know who her parents are, and of course her baby sister, Sweetie Belle. It takes a little bit of detective work to get a clear picture of what things were like for the sisters growing up. Let's start by taking a look at her parents. Her dad is Hondo Flanks. He's a pretty basic unicorn. He likes sports and enjoys fishing. Nothing too exciting there. Her mom is Cookie Crumbles. She loves her kids and likes to cook. Both parents seem to love the sisters, but it kind of seems like they have a favorite. In a lot of families, the youngest child gets the most attention. It kind of makes sense because younger kids need more help. In Rarity's family, we see a lot of attention paid to Sweetie Belle. Her mom gives her cooking lessons, which is so cute. Both parents are seen taking her to the fair. What did Rarity get from her parents? The responsibility of babysitting her little sister while they went on vacation? Sure, it's cool that they trust her so much. Doesn't Rarity get to have any fun with her folks? Twilight Sparkle. Artist Mighty 355 has imagined what Twilight Sparkle looked like as a baby. This precious pony is so cute we can't resist. Black M3SH made a series of the ponies as young fillies. Twi was definitely a cute kid. Twilight Sparkle is a lucky pony. She's not only really talented, but she has a family that backs her up no matter what.
I just want to see you all have a good time. And this works out perfectly because we have room for the one thing I want to do.
Her parents haven't been in a ton of episodes, but we do meet them a few times. Her dad is Nightlight and her mom is Twilight Velvet. They support Twilight in everything she does. When she has a flashback to one of her happiest moments, her parents are right by her side. In the fun memory, her parents show her an acceptance letter to Princess Celestia's School for Gifted Unicorns. She's thrilled to get into the prestigious school. And her parents are so proud, they even accompany her to her entrance exam. At the exam, Twilight Sparkle is doing pretty well until a sudden distraction throws her off. While she's concentrating, she's interrupted by a sonic rain boom that appears. Many people thought of the sonic rain boom as a myth before that moment. She had no idea that it was Rainbow Dash creating the colorful spectacle. It threw off her magic game so bad that she accidentally turned her parents into a cactus and an agave plant. Don't worry. Princess Celestia calmed her down and her parents went right back to normal. Even with that slip-up, Princess Celestia was still really impressed with Twilight. She even invited her to become a personal student. Her parents were right there to encourage her and cheer her on. It seems like Twilight Sparkle had a really loving family and a great childhood. Rainbow Dash. Have you ever wondered what Rainbow Dash's childhood was like? Everyone loves this spunky pony.
Keep it up! We're gonna need all the wing power we can get to break that record!
Yeah!
She's probably one of the most popular ponies on the show. A few episodes have given us a lot of info about her childhood. Artist Kamha has even given us a peek at what she looks like as a baby. Check out this adorable art of the pony when she was super young. How cute is this? Black M3SH gives us a look at Rainbow Dash as a spunky kid. That rumbled mane is precious. We've also gotten to know her parents. Her dad is Bo Hothoof. He kind of looks like Rainbow Blaze, and lots of people think they're related. Her mom is named Windy Whistles. Both of her parents love her a ton. They're really proud of their little girl, but they don't always show it in the best way. When she was a kid, her parents came to every competition she participated in. Having your parents in the stands to cheer you on may sound awesome. We all like it when our families support us. Rainbow Dash didn't get support, though. She got loud screaming and giant glitter signs. That was so humiliating for the young pony. The other kids made fun of her for her loud and rowdy family. That's not the only reason Rainbow Dash grew up under a lot of pressure. Her parents set her up to feel like she needed to be the best at everything she did. Her entire childhood scrapbook is full of photos of her parents grading her every move. From the start, she knew she was expected to be the best. Overall, it seems like her parents loved her so much that her childhood must have been pretty nice, even if she did feel pressured to be the best. We hope you like seeing these ponies as little colts and fillies. We'll see you next time.